Okay, so far what we have looked at is the structure, crystalline structure of materials, and how atoms are arranged under different crystalline lattices like FCC, BCC, HCP, and so on. And we have also identified the methodology, or we have actually discussed the methodology to describe crystallographic directions and planes, and how to identify them, how to represent them using Miller indices, how one needs to take care of representing equivalent crystallographic directions in the case of HCP, which requires you to use a 4-index notation as opposed to a 3-index notation usually used for cubic crystals, and so on, right? So the next important aspect that we need to look at is the imperfections in solids or imperfections in materials. Here we are only talking about materials in the solid state, and hence the topic is imperfections in solids. Okay. So these are the learning objectives. You should be able to list different types of defects in a solid, and then the we should be able to calculate the equilibrium number of vacancies or concentration of vacancies in a material at a specific temperature given the relevant vacancy formation energy. Okay, at different types of, list different types of solid solutions and give at least 5 examples for each of these types of solid solutions, and write the conditions for formation of the solid solutions that were listed in point 3, and you should be able to calculate the weight and atomic percentages of elements in an alloy, and you should be able to convert from atom percentage to weight percentage the composition, and we should be able to draw the schematics of an edge, screw, and mixed dislocations, and identify something called Burgess vector. List and draw schematics of different types of grain boundaries, explain the role of grain boundaries on dislocation motion, explain the strength of the nanocrystalline materials compared to their coarse grain counterparts, list different types of strengthening mechanisms, plot schematic variation of tensile strength, yield strength, and percentage elongation as a function of weight percentage of alloying elements in nickel in copper nickel system, derive the expression for critical resolved shear stress. So there are how many? Several learning objectives. So this is a very important topic. This actually helps us understand the deformation mechanisms that we have discussed, we will talk about in future in the last class, right? So this chapter, this topic module lays the foundations for understanding the deformation mechanisms. Okay, so in this class we will try to achieve these two learning objectives: the list different types of defects in a solid, and we should be able to calculate the equilibrium concentration of vacancies in a material at a given temperature, at a specific temperature, by knowing the vacancy formation energy of that particular material. Okay. So perfect crystals, are you familiar with any perfect crystal? Unfortunately, there is no such thing called perfect. Perfect crystals do not exist. So in some sense, philosophically, if you want to say, materials and human society are alike. They both work despite having defects. And several times, it is actually desirable not to have perfection. We may think that perfection is always good, but sometimes it is sought after. Imperfection is sought after. We will see in, particularly also in mechanical engineering applications, the defects are one of, are very important for us to actually make several things, right? So if you want to make a sheet metal, how do you make a sheet metal? You must have studied in your manufacturing technology or manufacturing processes course, or you are going to study. Okay, how do you make a sheet metal? So you actually have a billet, and then run the billet, iron billet or whatever, aluminum sheet metal, whatever, and then run between two rollers, and then it becomes a sheet. A solid block can be made into a sheet. The reason why you are able to make that into a sheet is because you can impart plastic deformation in the material. Imagine if the material is brittle. That means it will simply break. You will not be able to impart such huge amount of plastic deformation. And if not for defects, you will not have plastic deformation. You will not be able to impart plastic deformation. Right? Plastic deformation is actually the motion of one kind of a particular kind of defects in materials called dislocations. Right? So, in that sense, several engineering components can actually be made because of the presence of defects. So, many times perfection is not sought after. And they actually lead to many good things. The best example is semiconductors, right? Semiconductors work because of doping, because of adding impurity elements. So, you are adding some defect to the material intentionally to get something very nice out of it, right? So, useful imperfections, mostly most of the metals that we are familiar with are alloys. That means you don't have pure material, it is impure, it is not pure. That means it is not only one element. For instance, if you take steel, steel is an alloy of iron and carbon primarily, and there are going to be other elements too. So, but it is not purely iron, right? If it is purely iron, you probably won't be able to get the properties that you are actually enjoying with steel. So, alloying is something that you are actually making a pure material like iron as an impure material by adding other elements, but getting good things out of it, right? Similarly, semiconductor. So, now we need to define what do we mean by a crystalline defect. So, the crystalline defect is a lattice irregularity with one or more of its dimensions on the order of atomic diameter, right? It is a lattice irregularity. So, how do you classify these defects? So, that means there is some irregularity in the lattice structure that we have discussed in the previous chapter or previous module, right? So, how do you classify these defects? They can actually be classified based on the geometry of the or the dimensionality of the defect that we are talking about. So, as we are discussing, crystals with perfect order do not exist. Even if you want to, they do not exist. We will see in a moment why they do not exist. And imperfections or defects are there everywhere. And what are these different types of imperfections or crystalline defects? Okay. The first kind of defects are called point defects. So, zeroth order dimensionality, right. So, what are these point defects? For instance, if you have a crystalline lattice, if you have a vacancy or self-interstitial, that is one kind of a defect. Vacancy means if you need to have an atom there, but you don't have one. That means a lattice site which should have been occupied by an atom or a molecule is not occupied by that motif. So, basically you have a lattice site, but you don't have a motif. At every other place you have motif, but on that one particular place you don't have the motif. Then it is a vacancy. And a motif has specific position to sit in, right, the lattice sites. But if the motif goes and sits in some other position, which is not its lattice site, that which is where it is not supposed to be sitting, that is also another kind of defect. So, that is going and sitting in a place where it should not be, right. So, all of you have here lattice sites and you are all different motifs, right, for this classroom. And you are not expected to sit between the benches. If somebody comes and sits in between the benches, then he or she becomes the point defect for this nicely ordered class, right. So, that is what you mean by point defects. Right? You can also have impurities, which means normally you have a crystalline lattice such as iron, and then there is another impurity comes and sits in the crystal lattice, and that is what makes it an alloy, and you have you have these kind of materials called solid solutions, which we will discuss towards the end of this course, what different kinds of solid solutions. And then the next level of defects are called line defects. So according to dimensionality, the first one is zeroth order, and the second one is first order, second order and third order. So like mean that means point defects, line defects, next will be area or surface defects, and then will be volume defects. Okay, zero dimensional, one dimensional, two dimensional and three dimensional. So the line defects or linear defects are also called dislocations. That's what we will look at in detail in this course. And then you have interfacial defects or two dimensional defects or surface defects, right? So they have two dimensional description. So they are external surfaces, grain boundaries in a polycrystalline material. So grain boundaries are sort of defects, and face boundaries, twin boundaries, we will see what they are. And then you have bulk or volume defects, which means you have a crystalline material from the bottom up, and if you make your big actual structure, normally you would expect your atoms to be filling the entire space, and sometimes in your material you may find some voids, pores, right? It's a three dimensional defect where there is nothing, the material is not present for some reason, or some due to some reason that during the processing of the material this pore comes in, right? So this is a three dimensional defect. Similarly, cracks and foreign inclusions which are not supposed to be there in the material. So these are all the different kinds of defects that you have in a material: point defects, line defects, interfacial or two dimensional surface defects, and volume defects. Okay, so as we have discussed, imperfection is something that is not necessarily a bad thing. Okay, so several times imperfections we actually tend to get attracted to imperfections many times, even in society and even in people, right? So don't worry if you have an imperfection, probably that is attractive imperfection. Yeah.